So in the previous exercise, we built an overview display. So this is really good because it allows me to look at all four of my tanks and only when the temperature is over a certain level. But what if I want to look at more details of one tank? Well, in this exercise, we're going to create a new display to get more details for only one tank. So I'll do it for mixing tank one, but you can do it for any tank. Because as we've talked about, because they're all using the same template, when one is done, it's done for all of them. So let's start up with all the value symbols we asked to put on our displays. So I want to get the asset location and the asset name. So one other quick tip is that once we do the format for one, and we want to use the same format for the asset name, I can simply copy and paste. Then I can take the asset name and I can simply drop it over the same here, and there we go. We now have the exact same format. We'll now want to get both temperatures and turn them into multi-state. So since I'm already showing that I'm using mixing tank 1, there's no need to also show mixing tank 1 here. So we'll simply show that as the temperature. I'm also copying and pasting, and I'll do the same for the internal temperature. Great. Now let's turn that into a multi-state so we can quickly see what's going on. Feel free to configure the colors of your multi-state as you want. This is usually something that would require a little bit of the plant knowledge of what temperature should be highlighted. So I'll select them all and I'll just arrange them, make sure they're all aligned. Okay, great. Now all the values are done. So we're going to move on to adding our tables. So in the table, I'm adding both the internal and the external temperature. So depending on my need, I could decide what I want to add. In my case, I'll leave the value, units, maximum and minimum. Okay, great. Our table is done. Now let's move on to the trends. So in this database, the level forecast is also future data. So it allows me to predict what maybe the level would be. Okay, so I have the level in the trend, I have the temperature in the table, and then I have what my asset is. So let's add a couple of gauges to look at the percentage flow and the pressure. And then feel free to format it the way you want. In my case, once more, I'll just remove that it's mixing tank 1 because we already have it on top here. Okay, great. Now let's do our second gauge. So really, in this exercise, we really want to get as much detail as we want for one tank. So this is not something you would always look. You would probably go from the overview dashboard, and when something is going on, you can look at all the details. Okay, now we want to have a table with some of the static attributes. So in this table, because it's a static attribute, It does not make much sense to have a trend or to have a minimum and a maximum, so I'll remove those. Okay, great. So for this part of the exercise, this is about as much detail as we want to have for one tank, but feel free to add more details, add some graphic from the graphic library, or to add any more multi-state. So let's start with just saving it, and now we can inspect a little bit what happened in the last few days. Okay. So I want to know what the maximum and the minimum temperatures were over the last 12 hours. So let's look at the last 12 hours. So I'm changing the start time, and I'm going to leave the end time to be now. So if I look at the table has a minimum and a maximum column. So if I didn't have them, I could simply right-click and go and add those columns. So in this case, I can see the minimum for both temperatures and the maximum as well. So now it's done, it's saved. So we can move between the different tanks. So I got the maximum and the minimum for mixing tank 1, but I want to actually look at mixing tank 2 as well. And we can see that on multistate, the colors are changing because the values are not the same since we're looking at another tank. So I can look, I'm still looking at the last 12 hours. So great, now we have a tank details dashboard and we have a more overview dashboard. So what we want to do is link those displays together, and that's what we'll learn in the next demos and the next exercises, is how to link this detail dashboard with the overview to be able to quickly go from an overview to the detail of a tank that may have an issue.